Welcome back to another episode where we discuss how to implement our own database from scratch. In this video, we want to talk about indexes and see what is an index and how to implement indexes for our database. Indexing is a mechanism that we will use to reduce the iteration required to find a certain object within a collection or a dataset. A very common usage of the word index is within arrays. So if we assume we have an array of certain data size, which starts in the memory at address Y, each index can show how many times of X should we go ahead from the address Y to get the value of that index. So to get the value of index 0 here, we should go for the address Y plus 0, which is the first one, or the index 0 in this array. And to get the value of index 1, we want to find the address of here, which is the address of Y plus 1 times data size, which is X. And same goes for index 2. What we have seen so far looks like an array that is stored on the stack. What if our program, or just a part of our program or code, does not have access to all of this dataset and can only insert data into this dataset in random order? So maybe there is data in this portion, here, here, and here. Now that we don't know where the data that we want is exactly on this dataset, the only choice that we have is to iterate over it from the beginning to the end. While the actual relation between the stack and heap memory is more complex than what I'm describing in this video, in this case, the way that this problem is solved is like having another array in stack with 5 elements, where the value of each element is an address of the data in the heap or the larger dataset. This is again somehow like indexing. Instead of having to iterate over the larger dataset or the heap here, we can just iterate over this smaller array and find all of the elements that we are looking for in the larger dataset. Back to our database example, let's say we have a table with multiple rows. We assume that each table is stored in a single file. Now let's say that each row in our example table takes n bytes of size. To store this table on the file, we can turn each of these rows into binary data, allocate n bytes from that file, and store the binary data there. And if we keep doing this for other rows, it would look like we are filling this file block by block. Again, remember that in this video we are not talking about how do we store each row in the file, but we're talking about indexes. So the point for the database is not only to store the data, but to be able to retrieve the data. Maybe you want to find people with ages more than 10, which would be these two items. Or maybe you are exactly looking for the person with ID of 1. So the question is, how do databases find the rows that we are looking for as quick as possible? If we don't have any indexes, the database has no choice but to check each of these blocks one by one and see if they match our query. If they do, it will create a result set and adds pointers to the data that it found, which matches our query. Now, consider the fact that this was a database file. Iterating through all of the blocks in this file would be a very heavy operation. What databases do instead is that, based on different columns or fields, or maybe combination of them, they use different data structures to create indexes for this DB file. These data structures could be some sort of trees or even graphs. And for obvious reasons, these indexes are smaller than the actual DB file, and all of the index, or maybe a portion of it, could be loaded into RAM more easily. For the simple practice database that we are creating, we will be using B+Trees. And also, we will wrap our tree in a layer of LRU cache. We might later use other data structures, such as Bloom filters, but these two will be the ones that we will start with. So, before we head on to the next video, I really encourage you to watch this video by Abdul Bari. It's about B-trees and B+Trees and how they are useful in databases, and it would be a very good ground for our next topics. See you in the next video, and take care.